audio cable brain exploding. Okay, so my music goes to line two. My mic goes to line two.
We're live.
I need line two to go. Okay.
Why is the camera, the fan oscillating? Fuck. Alright, whatever. Whatever. Fix it all in a moment. Why does it say we are not live? What the fuck is going on here? Come on.
It's always something.
It says we have perfect streaming. What is going on? Oh, you know what? I went live on the wrong thing. Hold on. Where are you? I'm busy right now.
Excuse me. Okay, good. No, I was fucking around the cables. I don't know if I broke it. That's why.
Yeah, no, it's you're good. Come on. Initialize the fucking live stream so I can see what I'm doing. There. Thank you. Finally.
As I say, it just showed up on mine.
Okay, there we go. Good. Excellent. Chat won't load. So just gonna do a little something while we
you used that one.
Get
Yay.
Things up and running.
Wow, AC, wow.
Hold on.
Hi.
Sorry, they can't hear you right now, just hold on. There is method to my madness. So I was a little bit behind schedule today because just as I was getting all set to get the show going, my mom called, and then I had to get Rosie to bed, and then my ex called. So it's like, everybody in the world call me on the one night of the week when you know I'm going to be busy. That's great. Thanks, guys. Thanks. Appreciate that. Come on, you piece of fucking shit. Why are you taking so long? Go. Stop. Oh my god. Stop. Okay. I'm good now. Alright, here we go. So. Just gonna minimize this here. Okay. No. What am I doing? I'm so confused. Okay, hold on. We can do this. Get that out of the way. No. There. That's good. That's lovely. Okay. There we go. A familiar face, I'm sure, for many of you. Okay. Can't hear you, Skin Slip. I don't have the audio from the Google chat on. Yeah, okay. Alrighty. Okay, so we'll bring the gang in just a moment. For now, we got quite a bombshell of news today, namely that Dr. Number 11, Matt Smith, is officially leaving the series as of the Christmas special this year. Yes, which means we only have two episodes left. So I thought as a little tiny impromptu tribute, we'd take a look at... Well, this picture was one of the first publicity shots we ever got of him. Like, in character as the Doctor. And, so... Just a little tribute while I go have a smoke. and then the show can begin. And also to give everybody a chance to, you know, get here and stuff. All right. So talk to you guys in about now 5 or 6 minutes. Judging from the comments that we got while I was playing the Doctor Who theme of the 11th Doctor's run and the epic piece entitled I Am the Doctor, which seems to be a big fan favorite of the current soundtracks. Judging from the comments, we're going to have some rather heated discussion, as usual, about whether or not the 11th Doctor's run was any good. Well, fuck you all. I think it was awesome. Anyway, we'll get into that in just a few moments here. Let me just get the rest of the gang into the show. Just doing a bit of organizing here. Oh, where the fuck is my volume control? There it is. Thank you. And do we have the peeps?
Aye.
Okay. I can hear munching. I can see Stoud eating. It's what a lovely sight to be the first thing we see of the gang. I was attempting to type in the chat. Stoud put in the comments there, oh, he was an ugly doctor anyway. I was trying to type bans Stoud for trolling, but Livestream is being a dick and wouldn't let me type anything for some reason, so I don't know. Okay, god damn it. Trying to arrange, fix the things here. There we go. Okay. And let's get me in here as well. Hi. Oh, and that's lovely. That's lovely. My camera's frozen. 5 minutes in, and the camera's fucking frozen. Thanks, Livestream! Thanks! Appreciate it! First you won't let me type, then you freeze my camera. Instantly. We'll be right back, folks. We'll be right back. We're going to regenerate the live stream.
It's really sound player set up. Move the hangout over here.
I'm moving.
Thank you.
Yes.
I'm experiencing something interesting after getting rid of that crap that was on my computer.
I've not seen such bravery.
Yeah, what's going on?
Fucking video hell. And audio is reconnect live. Facebook then. Just reconnect Facebook. Is it that hard? Reconnect Facebook. It's saying I can't type anything unless I reconnect Facebook. Well, I was pretty sure it was connected. Great. Okay, there it is. It's connected. You just went to Facebook from my account, listed under connected accounts. Why can't I type in my own chat room? At least everyone else is able to type, so that's something. Come on.
I've not seen there. Such bravery.
What the hell? Okay, I don't know what's going on.
It takes a moment to connect, actually.
Well, I had clicked on it several times. It's really dumb. Reconnect, reconnect, reconnect. And every time I tried to type anything, it would say, you must reconnect Facebook. Why?
This calls for more alcohol.
Why does more Facebook $5 matter? Cabana I'm on live vodka. Stream. Who the fuck cares what I'm doing on Facebook right now? I'm on live stream. Anyway.
That's how it gives you the username and password and shit.
So there you go. So that was my
let me just pour myself on the break.
My little impromptu tribute to Doctor Number 11, Matt Smith. A couple of notable pieces of music from his run. The redone theme song. And of course the epic track, I Am the Doctor, which is great. I know a lot of fans like to listen to that one on repeat because it's so freaking epic and awesome. Yes.
Fuck. This week has sucked a bag of dicks. So, for that, I hope next week is better, and here's my cheers to you.
Now let me just find some of the douchey comments that Giant Guy was making.
Oh.
Giant Guy.
Oh, Giant Guy. What a cunt.
Oh, here it is. He says, He says, "Can't say I'm sad to see him go. The stories during his run have been awful." Strongly disagree. Very strongly disagree. Maybe we'll get something better with a new doctor. Then again, maybe the problem is Moffat. Again, strongly disagree. I really don't get all the hate directed towards Moffat, honestly. I think he's done a lot of interesting, unique, different, daring, experimental... You know, having the balls to actually do some reinvention and refresh the franchise in bold, new, interesting ways. I really don't get the hate at all. At all. I don't know what people want. You just want a monster of the week all the time? Is that all you want? Just a monster of the week like it used to be for a very long time? Nothing new or exciting going on? Because that's not how you keep a franchise alive for 50 years, by doing the same old thing all the time. I mean... I've enjoyed what Moffat's done very much, and I look forward to more, and I hope he sticks around for a while. I don't know. Funny thing is, I heard the same thing during Russell T. Davies' run. Oh, Russell T. Davies is totally ruining it, blah, blah, blah. And prior to that, I heard the same thing during John Nathan Turner's run. Oh, John Nathan Turner's ruining it, blah, blah, blah. I'm sure there were people who thought the same thing about Philip Ainsworth.
There's always going to be unhappy fans, and they're always the ones who complain so much.
Complain the loudest.
Yeah, they're the ones who complain. The people who fucking aren't unhappy.
And then if anybody actually likes it,
you're just
a Moffat fanboy.
Terrible.
You're just cancer.
That's it.
You're just a Russell T. Davies fanboy, and you're probably gay, too, because he's gay. Frank asked Sean, "Would you be pissed off if the 13th Doctor was a woman?" Let me address this right away. Okay, every single time there's a regeneration,
yes, because he's showing his pig.
There's people who say maybe the next one will be a woman. No, the next one will not be a woman. It will never be a woman, and I'll tell you why. It is firmly established in the lore and the canon of the series that the Time Lords are not asexual. They have males and females. There are Time Lords and Time Ladies. They do not spontaneously change sex when they regenerate. That's not how it works. You know, once they're male, they're always male. Once they're female, they're always female. So I don't get why this question keeps coming up. The first regeneration I ever saw was Tom Baker into Peter Davison. And... the first one that I actually sort of was privy to all of the fan speculation was the next one, the fifth into the sixth. And ever since that one, I've seen this question come up every single time. It's never going to happen, ever. It won't. It goes against the canon of the series. It would be ridiculous. So.
But, Sean.
Yes, skin slip. Yes, skin slip. Did we just lose skin slip? I think we just lost skin slip.
Yes, skin slip.
All right. There have been several Doctor Who spin-offs, actually. There was Torchwood is a Doctor Who spin-off. The Sarah Jane Adventures is a Doctor Who spin-off. K-9 is a Doctor Who spin-off. There was also another attempt at doing a Sarah Jane series back in the 80s. Is actually a K-9 series, but with Sarah Jane as one of the main characters. And that one didn't take off. It only did a pilot episode. But yeah, there's been several spin-offs. And other than K-9, K-9 you could argue is part of the canon but takes place in an alternate dimension. But Torchwood and Sarah Jane Adventures are very much part of the canon because they actually tie in. And the Doctor has even guest starred in some episodes of Sarah Jane, not of Torchwood. But the Doctor is mentioned in Torchwood a fair amount. Skinslip is having connection issues, apparently.
Let's see, in the Google Hangout, fuck, and in the live stream, fuck.
Stout says, Craig Charles should be the next Doctor, and then says, Roberto Benigni should be the next Doctor. Will Smith should be the next Doctor.
Hey, shut up. Those are two European actors who are fucking hilarious.
Well, this is true. This is true.
Simon Pegg.
Simon Pegg. I think Martin Freeman would be a great doctor, but honestly, I think...
Morgan Freeman.
Not Morgan Freeman. Martin Freeman. But he's... I think he's too big now, honestly. And a lot of people are saying, oh, Benedict Cumberbatch, because they love him in Sherlock and the new Star Trek movie, and it's like,
Everyone's a robot. Lovely.
No. No. No.
I am a robot.
Robot. Do you have anything running in the background? Anything?
I don't hate you.
Evan asks, do you think they could have a doctor of color? Yeah, I don't see why not.
That's what I'm thinking.
I don't see why not.
I'd like to see a purple doctor.
Giant Guy adds, I'm going to do an opinion video for YouTube soon, however Moffat may have won me back by taking the huge step in the last episode, adding a massive new element to the story in the form of John Hurt, if he handles it well. Yeah, a lot of fans are talking about that as if they know for a fact what's happened. It's like, oh no, he's the 12th Doctor, or he's the 8th and a half Doctor, which means we're going to have to change the numbering of all the previous Doctors. No. We're not going to have to change the number of all the previous actors. Whatever that character turns out to be, it's not going to be whatever we think it is. you fail to recognize that this is Stephen Moffat we're talking about here, and when has anything he's ever done ever been what you thought it was going to be? This is why I love him, and why I like the way he does stuff, because he loves to, A, troll the shit out of the fans, which I just adore him for, and B, he's very good at it, because... whatever crazy shit he's come up with, the one thing that he does better than anybody is pull the rug out from under the fans. So whatever we think it's going to be, that's not what it's going to be. You know, we might be on the right track, but honestly, I think we're missing something. And it's going to be something else.
I must get required Saturday Night Insanity Munchies.
I was saying that you're assuming that that gender is binary. That you know, you're born this sex and you're automatically that sex, but it's been known that you can be born a man and feel like you're a woman trapped in a man's body. Therefore, you could have a transgender doctor, because they were born a man or regenerated a man, become a woman during the series.
Well,
that would be fucking revolutionary.
Yeah, that's never gonna happen.
But it should, because it's fucking awesome.
That's never gonna happen. I mean, when Russell T. Davies introduced homosexual characters or bisexual characters, or in the case of Captain Jack Harkness, omnisexual characters, homophobic fans were outraged. It's like, oh, this is all just part of...
precisely the reason why you do that, by the way.
This is part of Russell Davies', you know, gay agenda, trying to brainwash our children. It's like, fuck you. Mm-hmm. All it is showing the universe in a more tolerant and open-minded light. I have no problem with that at all.
Gay people are totally trying to brainwash you into accepting them as people. God forbid.
Yeah, I know.
God forbid, you know?
Not to mention...
holy shit! Grand scheme to make themselves equal. Holy shit.
Oh, yeah, that's just right out. The thing is, I mean, Captain Jack is a great fucking character. He's a blast to watch as he's, like, hitting on every alien they encounter in their travels. And it's great.
That sounds awesome. That sounds like a character I would love.
Yeah, no, Captain Jack is awesome. I love him. And he was so popular that he became the main character of Torchwood. So he's in, like, one of the big spin-offs.
Oh, now I've got to see Torchwood.
Yeah, no, it's awesome. But, yeah, good fun. So I don't know.
By the way, I had the first season of the revival series, Sean.
Oh, okay. We should start watching it.
We'll start
watching, because I know you're eager to dive in. And you can rest assured you do meet Captain Jack for the first time in season one. So you get to get some Jack action.
Captain Jack sounds fucking awesome.
Some
exactly
Jackson
like
right
space.
Away.
You have one tit. I still want to fuck you.
See, Sean, this is what I was talking about.
Margarita.
By
Margarita.
In a can.
There you go.
Look how big this thing is.
Nice.
It's
a 24. I bet you the video of someone sticking something like that in their butt. There's got to be.
Thanks for that.
That. You're welcome.
AC mentions here, just going back to what we were saying, if the Doctor regenerated into you know, different race or a different color. He says, as a black man, I think just making the Doctor black, just because is the same as doing a woman. It's appeasement. I'd be more insulted by that than anything else. Well, there you go. He says, how about making a new Time Lady for a generation who is someone completely different because our Doctor isn't around, and he even gets saved by her? No, that's, I don't know, but like for a whole season, but maybe... maybe a two-parter or something. Or even better, make her a companion. Doesn't even have to be a man. Maybe it's a woman, or maybe there is no set companion for a while. More different. Yeah, well, I mean, that's
in the series.
That's what they did with Romana, because Romana was a Time Lady. So for the first time, the Doctor was with a companion who was quite literally his equal. You know, she wasn't as eccentric. She was more straight than he was, but very much equivalent intelligence, you know. And some fans liked it, some fans didn't, of course, as always. I liked Romana. And we even got to see her regenerate at one point, and she became a different Romana for a couple seasons.
That's cool.
Yeah.
But there's nothing saying that Doctor Who couldn't transition to another character, considering this may or may not be the last, you know.
Well, you see, so again...
apparently, in one of the episodes, he said that he regenerated dozens of times. So,
there was,
already, that might be a retcon.
No, there was a throwaway line that one of the Sarah Jane Adventures episodes that the Doctor guest starred in, where it was mentioned in conversation. It's like, I thought you could only regenerate 12 times. He's like, oh, no, there's no limit. I can regenerate as many times as I want. But... that has long since been dismissed by most people with, you know, brains as just a throwaway comment that ties into the whole idea of the Doctor lying all the time. He basically said that just so the person he was talking to wouldn't worry about him. But no, I think the limit is still very much in effect. For the simple, if anything, for the simple reason that it just creates, there's so much dramatic potential in having to deal with that limitation when they get to it, you know, and coming up with a story for him to get around it and beat it somehow, you know. I mean, it would be
and
a wasted
after that last regeneration. He becomes a normal human.
It would be a wasted opportunity.
Non-timeline.
It would be a wasted opportunity for them not to do something interesting with that. I mean, because it's been a firmly established part of the lore for so long that for them to just throw it away willy-nilly just wouldn't make any sense. It would be an insult to the longtime fans, quite frankly. And also, quite frankly, it would be damn lazy. Like, come on. Accept the challenge. Work with it. Make it work. I mean...
what's a challenge?
Because we all know, when he gets to the end, if they get all the way up to 13 lives, which the rate we're going, it looks like they will, of course they're going to find a way around it. You know? They talked about that as far back as the 80s. That, you know, they found a way for the Master to regenerate, because he was supposedly at the end of his regenerations. So the producer, John Nathan Turner, says, you know, if we found a way to do it for the baddie, we'll find a way to do it for the goodie.
And why not
as David Tennant comes back for the 14th Doctor, I'm good with that.
Oh, God. Are you a David Tennant fangirl, Zord?
Yes.
I should point out that I got into Doctor Who after your constant prodding in regards to the new series.
Yes!
So...
dick.
There's a lot of Christopher...
Elba has a doc. That'd be cool.
There's a lot of Christopher Eccleston and David Tennant in the Thrustbone camp over here.
Welcome to
another episode of Thrustbone Drinks a Beer. My name is Thrustbone, and this is my beer.
Frank asked Sean,
I already drank three drinks in the last like hour. I'm
slowly on my way.
Just one sec. Frank asks Sean, was there any Doctor Who episodes that got you all pissed off? No, absolutely not. Emotionally charged, sure, but I wouldn't say there's anything that got me pissed off. Like, they've never done anything in the show where I'm like, what the fuck did they do that for? It's not to say I haven't had problems with some of the continuity errors and stuff along the way. I mean, sure, it's just par for the course. But I wouldn't say there's anything that got me pissed off.
Also, skin
guys,
slip.
It's 4:30 a.m.
Three beers.
A ham and mushroom
one
pizza
hour.
And slurping cider. Dandy's chapter late, yet I feel a need to conform.
Suck it.
And I was like, you know you wouldn't miss us. You know it.
How's your new graphics card work in there? Frostbone.
The new graphics card, which is an XFX 47970 running on the ATI graphics chip, is doing pretty good. I just finished recording the inaugural episode of Thrustbone Gets Drunk while playing Resident Evil Revelations. So, I'm not horribly drunk in the first episode. I had a lot of driver problems with fraps and the new graphics card and trying to record.
That's always fun.
But
it seems, I mean, God love ATI and God love the Radeon cards, but it seems like all driver problems I hear about video games and recording, just
ATI
in general, seems to be revolving around Radeon cards.
I've had more blue screens.
What is with their...
I've had more blue screens due to ATI driver issues than anything else. It's the primary cause of my blue screens.
Well, you know what? When I first installed Windows 8, I'm running a bootleg version of Windows 7 now, but I bought a retail version of Windows 8, and I couldn't get it to work. I basically went on Windows 7. At the time, I was running an ATI 6700 series graphics card, and they said, yeah, that's your problem.
Which you should
still send to me. You're running a 6700 series graphics card and it just won't work with Windows 8. You need to update your graphics card and then you need to update your drivers if you want to run Windows 8.
Yes.
So having said that, as much as I like ATI and I like having, because I run an AMD chip and an AMD motherboard, I like to have all my stuff as uniform as I can. I kind of wish I bought a NVIDIA card. Just because
fewer
issues. I want the physics engine running on my system.
That shit is glorious.
I saw PlanetSide 2 running that made me like pop a wood. I was like, holy shit.
Yeah, but it doesn't take much for you to pop a wood there, skin slip.
No, it doesn't. But it does take a lot to make you want to fuck my screen. And this made me want to fuck my screen. So.
Yeah.
I make the boner easy, but I don't necessarily use it easily.
I am very happy that the 660 Ti series has just dropped under $200.
Having said that, I spent $500 on my current graphics card, so you're doing pretty good.
Feel free to send me your old card, because your old card is still way better than my current card.
I'll get to that when I've got the stuff.
Send somebody my new card, but the problem is the whole investment of me getting a new graphics card requires me selling my old one. So,
well, I understand that. I totally get that. He has a job, you don't. There's the difference here.
Yes.
Yeah, one of us builds robots, and the other one does not build robots.
Yeah, one builds robots, one has a license to build robots, but doesn't. So.
Hey, I'm going for my A+ at some point.
There's a new Humble Bundle this week with all the Telltale games in it. So it's got the Back to the Future game, the Walking Dead game, Sam and Max, the Wallace and Gromit game, and like some other game I can't remember.
You can get the Walking Dead game if you pay over the average. That's their
which is $5 currently.
Yeah. Although if you're in Canada, you're looking at $78
just
for the
down to my table. I'm okay.
It's still
the average.
The Humble weekly sale is $5 American, $6 Canadian.
Oh, Stout, I picked up that Indie Royale bundle that has gas guzzlers and stuff on it. I have been playing the shit out of Pressure. Holy crap, that game is...
It looks awesome.
It's addictive as hell.
£3.
It's so simple, too.
So now I have all these games I don't know what to do with.
Well, you could play them.
Yeah. There are video games.
There's a sense in that.
I mean, this is coming from the guy...
Yes, video games, you should play them.
This is coming from one of the guys who spends on average $60 to $70 a week on Steam and doesn't pay the games that he pays for.
Yes.
But take my advice and play the goddamn games. Because the indie games...
PlanetSide 2.
The indie games are getting better and better, and especially in comparison to the so-called AAA titles that companies like EA and BioWare. Yeah,
indies this are is starting why... to blur the line between AAA and indie.
And this is exactly why, when I see fucking Microsoft saying, oh, we're not going to let indie developers use our new console, it's like, then you're going to lose.
Fine.
You're going to fucking lose, because people want the indie games, because indie games are fucking better.
Yeah.
This, see, the 360 built its reputation on its indie-friendly platform called the 360 Arcade.
It almost killed the PC. It almost killed the PC gaming. It almost did.
Yeah, it exploded when they announced XNA, man. It was all about XNA when that was first announced, and they had the whole, you could build a game using some of the XNA tools on C++ and using XNA tools on your PC and directly load them onto your system without needing any Microsoft help or support. That was just fucking legendary.
Yeah.
I admit, I'm not a developer. I even had an XNA account for the mere fact that people were beta testing games and they would give you the games to sideload.
Yeah. I mean, the Throstbone game that I was working on was coded with the XNA library. And now they're saying that it won't be able to run on the new Xbox. And remember,
Microsoft has completely dropped off XNA.
Yeah, it's basically going to become a Windows platform, in which case I can find a better engine to run the Thrustbone game. But
I recommend
coming from a guy... went to x86 architecture, that's why.
Yeah. I got to say that as a guy who's owned the original Xbox and played the 360 exclusively when it comes to consoles, I am not happy with the way that Microsoft is treating its audience and treating the developer community.
Yeah,
absolutely not.
I totally agree with that. It's just, they're
dropping before, the ball big time.
Back in the early days, before we maybe have known each other less than a year, a lot of people, especially Stout, will tell you, and Sean, that I was primarily a 360 player. I had an Xbox. I didn't have an Xbox PS3 until about 6 years ago.
But then we kidnapped him and put him into one of our re-education camps. And and now he's all better. So
then ever since then, I've been a PS3 owner. But yeah, I had an XNA account. I had all that. I played a lot of games that never saw the light of day on my Xbox. And I still have it. That little red thing right there is my original Xbox.
Oh, there you go.
So I'm still a huge fan of that.
The
original.
That would be fucking awesome, because that was a great system right there.
Mm-hmm.
So
that's the thing that almost killed the PC. That and doing the whole XNA and all that stuff. PC gaming was on a decline, and Xbox looked like they were fucking taking a sword and stabbing fucking PC gaming. And then out of nowhere, we're just like, fuck you, we don't want to get rid of our PCs, and we want all the consoles in our PC and shit.
Yeah. And a big part of that is coming from...
No, a big fucking mistake.
A big part of that, in my opinion, though, is coming from the Kickstarters and the Indiegogos and... the old school PC guys coming back and making games on crowdfunding. Like, look at the Wing Commander guy is making Star Citizen, which is a game that I've personally put $200 into backing.
Nice.
And I can't wait for that to come out. And then, of course, the guy who made Ultima
I gave him $5
is coming back.
Yeah.
Well, the guy who made Ultima is making a new game on the PC.
There's a new Ultima style game coming out. There is a reboot of DuckTales, obviously.
But that
can't fucking wait for
PC?
That.
Yes.
Yeah,
it is coming out for the PC, so I have even less reason to turn my 360 on now.
The DuckTales game is going to be on the PC. let's see what else.
Is it really?
One of the games, one of them that surprised me was the Gianna Sisters game, the Twisted Sister. That one came out. And if anybody's any kind of like nostalgic gaming back to the Apple II and the MS-DOS and the DOS games, you'll remember the Mario ripoff called the Gianna Sisters.
Yeah.
also,
they have that on the Amiga. Great Gianna Sisters.
Yeah, there was an Amiga version.
The new game soundtrack is done by Mackinac Supremacy, who's a fantastic Sith metal band.
So. Oh, and also there is another, there's actually kind of hidden right now because it's only on the Ouya, is a Ouya version of the original Giana Sisters.
Nice.
Holy shit, my webcam's on. Why didn't anybody tell me?
I figured you knew.
We just thought it was, you know, part of the joy tonight.
What's wrong
we
with
get
that?
To
yeah.
see You're, the mighty thrust.
We figured
on.
You knew.
Well,
you
holy
were
shit.
Up.
There's only one thing we can do shit. If the fucking webcam is on.
He's
gotta
top
get,
hat?
Gotta get top the top hat. Yes!
I
was gonna comment on
it. I asked you where your top hat was.
There you go.
Awesome. Of course, I had to hold my fucking headset up to my ear like this for the rest of the night because I can't wear the headset and the top hat at the same time.
So it's like you're the top hat DJ.
It's like being back in broadcasting school before they kicked me out for losing my virginity and not going to class.
That sounds like Arthur Rusbaugh.
But yeah,
which is funny because I lost my virginity when I was 14, and I went to college when I was 17. So, I don't know what I did wrong, but.
Burb. But, yeah, I figured you knew your camera was on because you were showing your beers and stuff like that.
Yeah.
So we.
I show my beer every time.
Even when the camera's
you guys
not
are
on.
Just lucky I'm wearing pants tonight. Let's put it that way.
The pants are on? That won't last very long.
Nope. Wait, is
Stoutman
so, drinking alcohol?
Slipple will have his shirt off. Thrustbone will have his pants off. Between the two of them, they will be
it's
one complete naked man.
But it's still fucking alcohol.
And Pablo is drinking cider. Sean, what are you drinking tonight?
Nothing.
Nothing?
Water.
Well, you know what? I get my refund for the Yeti next week. I'm going to send you some money for booze, and we're going
to
drink.
Awesome. It'll have to wait until, not next week, but the week after, though, because I got Rosie right now.
So. Well, I mean, we can't give Rosie any booze.
No.
Unfortunately.
But,
I would.
Well, yeah, definitely.
But I can't.
And show you some awesome.
If you want to send me booze, buddy, I'd be down with that.
Cut into my Doctor Who fund then.
I'm sending Crimson some booze money, and I'm gonna send Stoud some booze money.
Oh fucking
because...
A. Party time.
Nice.
Well, time it so it's a week and I don't have Rosie, and then we'll drink it up. I'm not actually, despite what some of my viewers apparently think, I really don't drink that often.
Nobody drinks more often than Thrustbone.
I literally
well,
drink
Well, I wouldn't
maybe
say that.
For breakfast, I have cereal and vodka.
I wouldn't say that. I think there's one person who drinks more than Thrustbone.
Metal Madness.
Frank asks, how's Rosie? Rosie is great, actually. She lost one of her front teeth recently because her big teeth are coming in fast.
No!
And she's about to lose the other one, so she'll lose the two big ones in the middle, which kids always seem to lose first.
Yeah,
she's actually already got all her grown-up teeth in the bottom, like the bottom front. So,
wait. So is this her first experience with tooth loss?
No. She's lost like five now, I think.
So she's used to getting toonies from the tooth fairy.
She likes. She has no problem with it. Like I was always a bit of a wuss when it came to pulling out the loose baby teeth, but she's just like, look, it's loose, I'm going to try to pull it out. No, it's not ready to come out yet.
If I needed money, I had no problem grabbing a Kleenex and just yanking my teeth out so I could afford lunch.
Like, damn, school. Kid, you're hardcore. Rosie.
What can I say? Thrustbone is punk rock and metal at the same time.
There you go. Why have I made so
I like
little,
how Byron is just laughing at the absurdity of that comment. It's almost like it's the first time.
AC says, speaking of, I didn't forget what I said about Akira. I gotta set something up.
Oh, man.
I've forgotten what you said about Akira. I don't know if that was directed towards me or Skinslip or...
What?
Windows is actually the only thing I give Microsoft money for. Because the way I look at it is your operating system is the heart and soul of your computer. I don't want to fuck around with that.
I don't give Microsoft money for anything.
It's not like I steal other stuff from Microsoft, not at all. I just don't use Microsoft products at all. I use Windows, and that's it.
Everything else has an alternative.
That's free. Exactly. When it comes to like Office Suite, I use OpenOffice. You know, it's legitimately free, developed by Sun Microsystems, the creators of Java.
Actually better, because it doesn't crash as much.
Yeah. One, it's lower system usage, too, which is good.
So, what is this that I heard people were asking where I was over the past couple weeks?
Just once. Someone asked where you were.
Every day.
Someone go to your head.
Hell, once a day makes me feel good.
Who were these people and how might I reward them? For not forgetting their lord and master, Thrustbone.
Hey, I mean, I was going to leave that part out, but if you're going to bring it up, yes, I am the Lord of Masters.
You and Skin. Oh, right. Okay, I remember now, AC. Yeah. That'd be awesome.
What would be awesome? I'm sorry, I missed it.
Just read the text chat quietly to yourself.
Oh, yes. Holy shit. I will name drop the shit out of you for at least a week worth of live shows and shit that I do. So, I will make sure you get fucking credit for being awesome.
Wait, so you're gonna name drop him once?
No, I do other shows.
I gotta go see if
I
have some
things.
Popcorn that I can make, and then if I do, I'm gonna make some popcorn.
I guess last week I did 2 guest spots on other movie podcasts, so I do other things around the internet, goddammit.
Hey, where's Dolan?
There is... Well, let me put it in the chat. AC, send me a message or send me a comment via Twitter, twitter.com/skinslip, and I will give you a link to that. Just follow me there, and I'll follow you back, and I'll send you a direct link to said file. Oh, okay, you had that one. Never mind. Yes. Oh, I already have a copy of the FLAC and the MKV on my computer.
Hold on a second. I'm going to change headsets.
If you could... Yes, but, like, I want that. Is it going to come with a cover?
Wow. I can't believe that was the problem. I can't believe that's what was causing the lag.
What was wrong?
Oh, like it. No, this is not in general. This is like an after thing problem I was having with like audio and video lag, making everything sound like drunk Jeff Goldblum.
Nice.
I went and I started uninstalling things to see if I could figure out what it was. Of course, it had to be. I was like, I wonder if it's some kind of a issue with. Malware bytes and adware, you know, competing with each other at the same time.
Right.
So I get rid of malware bytes because adware was the one that fixed my computer, so fuck malware bytes.
Malware bytes is actually the best, though. Just letting you
know. Doesn't matter.
It's okay.
Didn't work. So fuck that. Anyways, that's how I judged
it. Did you use it yet?
Which one worked? Actually, I did. I used it first and I didn't find the issue.
I hate you.
Anyways. Got rid of malware bytes, kept adware, and the issue seems to be gone. The lagging video, gone. Now I'm not saying that's all because of malware bytes. I'm just saying that like the two together on the system are like, I don't like this. I don't like this either. Holy shit, Metal Madness.
Holy shapeshift and sheepshit, Batman.
Hey, Alex, you here? I know you're in the chat room.
Am I here yet? There I am.
There you are. Yeah, you are here. And then we got the madness.
The madness
is running wild. Metal madness run wild over you.
Cheers, my peeps.
Oh, Jesus. Cheers.
Ah, stop.
I already followed you back, AC.
Is that Justin?
Justin?
Zwart?
Yeah, it might be Top Hat, yeah.
I thought he was dead.
I'll have to find a cover for that AC.
Look at these two guys. These two That's guys cool. like. I appreciate it. Sorry, can't Metal make it Madness to see Super Mario Brothers.
Can't. No. Oh, best part. They couldn't come to their own podcast to watch Super Mario Brothers. Their own fucking podcast. And they didn't show up. I know why Metal didn't. He was fucking exhausted to that. His week was a bag of dicks. Also, it's fine. But. Fucking Thrust over here. Oh, I'm out. Well, fuck you. Podcast. Yes. This week was a bag of dicks. This was the worst week I've had in a long fucking time. Just ask Joker. Just ask Madness. I fucking kid you not. This is the worst week on record for a long fucking time. Jesus.
It's all in the
Joker
past.
Joker lost his fucking job. And had a tree try to kill him. He had had two very terrible things happen today. Meta probably had him deal with a bunch of dickheads.
Alright, yeah, I've should come see back.
The post on Facebook. His car has a giant divot in it from a tree falling on it.
Yeah.
It fucked the front all up and shit.
Metal.
It's like $2,800.
What's up, Thrustbone?
You drinking tonight, right?
Of course I'm drinking.
Well, here's
three sheets
bud.
To the wind already, motherfuckers. I was drinking before the show. Here's my empty glass. I'm gonna go get some mixer, I'll be back. I wanna drink with you guys. Oh god. Hopefully I don't die falling down the stairs.
So here are a few things in regards to the Thrustbone. Next week I will be on the movie Gangbang for sure.
Yay!
For sure.
I've cleared Saturday and Friday on my schedule to make sure that whatever fucking day you guys decide that you're going to record on, I'm going to be there.
Cool.
Yes.
Because somehow you guys decided to change the recording date from Saturdays to Fridays without letting me know.
Well, it was always Fridays, I thought.
No, it was Saturdays for the first time.
The first time was Saturdays.
Oh, okay.
And then you guys were all like, hey, let's pull one over on Thrustbone and start recording on Friday.
I didn't do jack shit. Skin Slip is the mastermind, man.
Hold on. Hold on. This is probably the shittiest soda I'll ever drink. It's called Stars and Stripes Cola. It's 3 liters.
Oh, 99 cent
97
cola?
Cents. Yeah. It's fucking horrible, I'm sure. I'd not tried it. It's my first taste test.
Hey, man. 79 Miss cent.
Yeah.
79 cent cola. Good fucking cola.
I'm surprised you didn't get the HEB cola. That stuff is actually really good.
I drank my last bit of HEB cola. This was given to me by the convenience store across the street lady.
Oh, nice.
She's like, here. I'm like, okay.
Have you actually tried any of her food yet?
Mm. Oh, that's fucking awful. This needs
alcohol.
It's
bad. Yeah, it's bad.
Hold on. $5 shitty alcohol with $1 shitty soda.
It's
fucking epic.
You're going to feel rough in the morning, man.
Only in America could you get alcohol for $5. Because in Canada, you gotta spend at least $15.
Oh no, this is not good. This is terrible. This is literally gasoline in a bottle. In fact, this is cheaper than going to the fucking gas station.
I didn't say that $15 alcohol was good. I said that's what you gotta spend in Canada to get alcohol.
That's because you have fucked with the surcharges and shit.
Canada, they are way more expensive when it comes to food and everything.
And books.
Yeah, books are really expensive.
Fucking waste on books for no reason. The dollar and the Canadian dollar, or I don't know what you guys call it, is pretty similar.
We call
price.
It a dollar,
you still have to
asshole.
Pay...
We're not that different than you guys.
I'd say you guys get fucked, though, because we'll pay $8 for a novel. You guys still have to pay $15, even though our money is pretty much the same.
What are you talking about?
Yeah, it's true.
A novel?
We ended up getting fucked on prices.
A novel's like 10.
Talking about how everything is more expensive in Canada than it is in the United States.
Those of us in Canada...
Whatever.
It's $8.99 in the U.S., $9.99 in Canada... In Canada.
For the longest time, it was $6.99 and $10 for you still, okay?
Hell.
So, I look at the back of books.
If you're smart, if you're smart, you'll just go to the library and check that shit out for
this
free.
This is $7. This book's $7 US, $10 Canadian. You guys are getting fucked. I'm sorry.
It depends.
That's unfair to you guys, because their dollar's practically the same as ours value-wise right now.
Well, sometimes it's worth more. It's just been a few cases recently where it's actually been worth more than the US dollar.
Yeah,
absolutely, which means you should be paying $7 and we should be paying
$10.
Well,
hold on, before you go into a ball of rage on our behalf.
I'm a little drunk, I'm sorry.
when our dollar was worth more, or more or less the same, a lot of the comic stores would sell the trade paperbacks for the U.S. cover price.
Yep.
Just in Canadian dollars.
Wow, that's perfect.
Yeah.
That's great.
Cool.
I love that.
Because obviously they can't do a whole
new
print run to reflect the new price, but they adjusted their prices.
Now,
that's cool.
Mm-hmm.
Coming from a manufacturing
standpoint. Hi, Mia. Hi, Metal.
What's up, dude?
Coming from a manufacturing standpoint, when our dollar was at par with America, a lot of people wouldn't take our imports because it would cost more money for them to import it than they could sell it for.
Yeah.
So a lot of the robots that my parents were making at the time are just being sold now to America.
Oh,
and
wow.
We're just now making a profit on something that I built 4 years ago.
Oh, wow. That's crazy.
So enjoy your comic book pricing while I starve and...
I have been.
That's so sad.
Yeah.
So, Alex, where do you get your Stars and Stripes cola from?
The 99 cent store.
Okay.
The 99 cent store has... Yeah, it's horrible. I think ours is only 2.5 liters now. I think reduced it, though.
Yeah, this is 2.5 liters.
Anyone else can confirm that one? Because I'm pretty sure it's less than 3 liters now.
It's so old it doesn't have a date.
Oh, hey, Nicole's here. Hi, Nicole.
I can't see who's here because I forgot to load up live stream.
I was just making a very sad bucket of popcorn. Normally I make so much popcorn that it literally won't all fit in this massive bucket. But I've neglected to get some more recently, so I was barely able to make like a quarter bucket today, and that's all I have left.
Sorry, culture.
Oh well. So if you want to come over and bring me some popcorn, I'll be forever in your debt.
He'll go down on you if you bring him some popcorn.
There you go. Well, I do that anyway, but, you know, popcorn would just sweeten the deal.
That's only gentlemanly.
Mia's fucking beautiful. Everyone be nice to her.
What the fuck?
Who wasn't?
He's already drunk, Mia.
I know. I'm like, did I miss an insult from my head?
He was loaded before we even started.
My day was poop. My week was poop. Today was actually okay.
I cleaned my house, so I just got done scrubbing the floors.
Yeah.
So you get yourself a beer, lady. You deserve
it's
Miller time.
I want a beer, lady.
Let's examine
the perspective. Let me know when you find one.
Let's examine Crimson's housing situation for a moment.
Oh, uh-oh. God.
Yeah.
Do we have to?
Her brother, her sister-in-law, and the kids that she lived with have all gone away for the weekend. And what does she do with her newfound...
Exactly! Fucking exactly!
She cleans her fucking house! She does the exact same thing
well,
that she does
hold on,
everybody
hold on,
is home.
Hold on. Just stop. Hold it. Because it's the only time she can clean the house, and it will actually stay clean for more than 5 seconds.
It's clean enough that it doesn't have nasty, dirty odors in the house. Like, it smells like Pine Sol, and I'm happy with that.
Mia wants to enjoy her free time.
Yes.
Oh, I love the smell of Pine Sol.
Exactly.
Because I can clean properly.
Instead of smelling rotting things everywhere.
Oh, God. Don't even get me started on their bathroom.
Oh, dear.
I gotta say one thing, though.
Actually, my bathroom is pretty nasty, too, so I shouldn't really talk, but...
Thanks to Crimson, I had steak for dinner instead of Hamburger Helper because she stepped in and was like, you're not eating that shit. Slap, slap, slap. You go get yourself a steak.
That's going to be Monday for me. I'm expecting some money to come in. So Monday's going to be steak night.
John, the reason why you can talk shit about the bathroom is because you had to clean your own bathroom. You're not having me clean it, so it's okay that your bathroom's fucking destroyed.
Wow,
it's not okay that they destroy the bathroom and make her clean.
Oh, that's true, yeah.
The upstairs bathroom has the shower. And if the bathroom smells where I need to shower, that's not acceptable.
Exactly.
That's disgusting. I should not take a shower and come out and still feel nasty. That's nasty.
Yes.
This is the
odor
terrible.
That sticks to you.
Now, see, this is why Odorous Urungus has metal under his thumb. Because Odorous doesn't want to smell odor when he goes to shower. He gets metal to clean up after it.
Even though I am the Lord and Savior, I do have to do my duties from time to time.
Literally, my
duties. Can I just say, I love you guys.
Distinguished titles earn them by being clean and awesome, all right?
So
I love each and every one of you.
Just remember, when we get a compound...
Are you drinking too, Stout?
We're getting fucking maids. Because I'm not cleaning up after your bachelor asses.
Suddenly, the
nice
real reason everyone wants you in the compound becomes painfully clear.
You know what the sad thing about the compound will be? Every room that we're in will look exactly like the rooms that we're in now. So it'll be like we never moved. It'll just be like the six of us living together.
They'll never come out of their
talking
rooms.
Talking to each other on camera.
The best part is we won't even talk to each other except through webcam.
Yeah.
I'll be the only one in our house.
You're like 12 people.
We won't hang out at all.
It's like, yeah, you should come over and watch a movie. I don't want to walk all the way down the hall. can't we just Beatles something instead?
Can you upload this to Dropbox? Instead of walking a thumb drive down the fucking hall? Oh, God. Brilliant.
Speaking of Beatles, Mia and I watched the first episode of American Horror Story last night, and oh my God, how did we miss that series?
I need to see that. I've had my eye on that for a while.
I hear the second season goes off the rails a bit.
Well, from what I understand,
bloop, blah, bleep.
Every season will be different from the season before it, so there's a different cast of characters in the second season than there was in the first season.
Gotcha.
But it all takes place in the same house as the same town. Just different people living in that house.
I had a friend just say to me, by the way, speaking of Doctor Who before, Simon Pegg is the Doctor, Nick Frost is his new companion, and Edgar Wright doing guest show running.
God.
I'm sold. I'm sorry. fucking money. Just take it.
So... Dan Robert Head asks, do you think Doc 12 will be unknown, meaning like someone we haven't heard of before? Honestly, I think yes. I think it might be someone who's relatively known in the UK, but not as well known over here.
That's been
the case most of the time.
I can shed some light on that. The 12th Doctor will be me.
Damn it.
Yes.
Does non-disclosure agreement not mean anything to you? I mean, seriously.
Gimp slap,
give
do
me
it.
Some more beer.
Perfect.
I wear a top hat now. Top hats are cool.
Blue slips, sink ships. let's go all the way with it.
Yes, that's right,
blue
America.
Slips, sink
amazing
ships.
Time traveling blue box. Put your money in the top hat. Could you imagine, though, if the Doctor was just, like, a raging alcoholic and he was like, give me more booze or I'm not fighting the Daleks.
Exterminate. Get drunk instead.
James Watley says, don't destroy me for saying, but I haven't watched any Doctor Who. Where should I start? Start with the Series 1 of the current series with Christopher Eccleston and go from there. Yep. That's the best place to start if
for
you've never seen
it before. For most people these days, it's easiest to start with the new Who.
Yeah. It's the most accessible to a modern viewer. And then after a while...
Me and Sean are going to start watching New Who soon.
After a while, when you get curious, go back and check out some of the old ones later.
I'm going to start me out from the old ones.
That's what I did. I started with the New Who, and then Sean gradually introduced me to the first Doctor.
Mm-hmm.
And I started watching the second Doctor on my own, and
mm-hmm.
It's funny though, because the new Who is basically an action series, whereas the old Who was a mystery series.
Kinda, yeah, there's a lot more mystery. I mean, there's mystery in the new series too, but it's definitely not as heavy on the action. It depends where you watch though. Like, a lot of the third Doctor stories were very action heavy. It was like the
Maddox
James Bond Doctor.
Inebriate.
I'm four beers ahead of you, brother.
4 years?
A lot of work.
God, this thing's killing me.
Hey, Raptor's here.
Raptor Rivera in the house.
The one, the only dinosaur dude is here.
That's right. Dinosaur dude.
Still no Garland. Let's all get the next George Carlin to join us.
Oh, I'm sure he'll be here at some point.
But he's not here now.
No.
I'm just not willing to accept
that. He doesn't
usually
show up before midnight. That's his time.
Oh. Well, see, Dahlin, unlike us, does other things during just the day other than internet stuff. So, yeah.
Screw you. I skipped out on Movie Gangbang to do other stuff last night.
You missed a good one.
That's why you're not on it. It's your own show.
That's why he keeps bringing me in, because he needs a Canadian on the commentary. By the way, speaking of which, Movie Gangbang, we did another episode last night. We did Super Mario Brothers, the live-action movie. It was actually the very first time I'd ever seen it. I somehow just never got around to watching it. It's the 20th anniversary this year, so I figured, well, I've put it off for 20 years. I guess it's time to watch it. So
God,
you get to hear me
that day.
You get to hear me see Super Mario Brothers for the very first time ever, and all my hopes and dreams slowly get sucked away progressively over the course of the commentary. Definitely check that out. The link is on the Facebook page.
It was so hopeful at the beginning. It was hilarious.
I was just about to ask you for a 5-word review, but you just gave us that, so I'm not even going to bother.
He just progressively got more and more frustrated over the fucking movie. He starts sighing heavily, and he's just like, you have a fucking point to make you go higher! Why are you jumping on their heads?
Yeah. Well, you got the sound effect, but no head jumping. What the fuck?
One of the things that I couldn't
you
understand
have a
is
mushroom in your hand. Eat it!
Eat it! Makes it grow and become a shield or some stupid shit.
Yeah.
It's horrible.
I couldn't figure out, even in 1993 or 1992, whenever that movie came out, I couldn't figure out how they wanted Mario to ride that little thumbnail of a dinosaur that they called Yoshi.
Well, they didn't. They just didn't even go there. The end.
And then the fucking
Yoshi went badass.
And then the Goombas with the super scope. I was convinced that that whole movie was just an advertisement for the ill-selling super scope at that point.
But it didn't look anything like it because it was painted completely different. That's not helpful. It just decided to do it with the reference.
Never, Mauricio. We don't do TV shows on Gangbang. We just do movies, hence the name Movie Gangbang.
I've brought up the idea of doing poorly drawn animated series on the Gangbang before.
Yeah.
Skinslip shot that down pretty fast. Because I was we could watch poorly translated anime. And he was like, no. Movies only.
No.
Well, we could if it's a movie.
No.
Like, if it's just a movie.
Exactly. Like, we could watch Raiders of Galaxy. Fuck, that would be a fucking horrible movie to watch. Or, like, what was that, Solar Thunder Kids or whatever? We can watch shitty fucking Korean animated movies, but we can't watch TV shows, was my only stipulation at the time. I think you just misunderstood me, or I misspoke because I was long like, no! Movie Gangbang! It's gotta be a movie! Give me a TV movie, but let's look at the word movies and
no!
No!
My shirt.
You'll be happy to know there's a guy who plays in my guild on PlanetSide 2 who uses Skeletor and Snarf voices. while killing things.
He's like, "Narf, I'm out of ammo."
I was suing for plagiarism. only I can plagiarize those things.
I was like, "Is your name Matt?" He's like, "No, my name's John." I'm like, "Well, fuck you." And that's all that you have heard. Because he would only use those voices, and I'm like, "What the fuck?" Mauricio, we don't care about it being a big audience. We do cult films with small followings like fucking Silver Bullet or The Brood. Like, we don't do fucking Terminator 2. We'll never do Terminator 2.
It's about having fun, and, you know.
Although we did do Army of Darkness the other day, but that hasn't gone live yet.
That's a cult film. Yeah,
it's called Masterpiece.
The thing about Army of Darkness is that they use Metallica in the trailer. And as a Metallica fan, I can't make fun of anything they've ever been a part of. Even Death Magnetic, as much as I want to. It's like, I get so many jokes, but it's like James Hetfield. Every time I want to make a joke about Death Magnetic, he punches me in the face and knocks me out.
Death Magnetic is better than Saint Anger.
Well, yeah, but we just choose to ignore Saint Anger altogether because it's Saint fucking Anger.
Because it's an Entombed album disguised as a Metallica album, that's why.
It's not even an Entombed album. I would say that it's a Strokes album
disguised as the solos on Saint Anger. Fucking guitar solos are badass.
Yeah, absolutely. And that's why I have the instrumental version.
Wait, fuck the shit of singing. There's an instrumental version of Death Magnetic?
Yeah, it's part of the demo magnetic stuff. What happened was, because the whole Saint Anger was released on Guitar Hero, so I'm going to extract the instrumental stuff and enable them to combine it to make instrumentals only.
That I heard about. And I heard Metallica was really upset about that. No surprise.
Yeah. That's what you get.
What you get.
That's what you get for not being metal, Metallica.
I like Death Magnetic. I don't know why people didn't like it.
Well, because
Death Magnetic, it was okay.
To quote Squizgar Squiggle from Death Clock, if use not metals, use dildos.
Death Magnetic is okay. There are some good songs, but fuck, man. Metallica is my problem.
The problem with Death Magnetic, as somebody who reviewed it, and the Death Magnetic review was my first YouTube video, the problem with Death Magnetic was that there's some really inspiring work on it, but all that inspiring work is like sandwiched in between all this shitty 90s Metallica work that they did on Load and Reload.
Except I like Load and Reload, and I don't think it has anything to do with Load and Reload. It's not even good enough to be considered Load and Reload. That's how much I don't like.
Wow.
Load and Reload is actually decent, like, progressive rock. Fucking Death Magnetic is a pile of shit with some good shit thrown inside.
Progressive rock, yes, but metal, like it's not.
It's a shit Twinkie.
Absolutely. And Death Magnetic is definitely metal, but it's like a pile of poop with some fucking broccoli grown out of it. There's some good stuff in there, broccoli. But surrounded by all the stinky shit.
It's a turd covered in ice cream sprinkles.
having said that, we do have a new Black Sabbath album to look forward to. We have a new Alice in Chains album to look forward to.
Ooh,
and we have a new Gwar album to look forward to this year.
Which I'm excited for.
The world of hard rock and heavy metal continues to march on in the absence of a decent Metallica album.
And if you're into power metal, Civil War's album comes out in June. Sabaton's releasing an album early next year. Hammerfall, Blind Guardian, and Helloween are all releasing new albums either late this year or early next year. So all those power metals releasing all two, and I love power metal. So.
Let's not forget that Jason Newsted's full-length album is coming out.
Finally.
If you've heard the Newsted album LP, you know that it's going to be good shit.
Oh, I-Rate, you mean? I-R-8?
Yeah, sure. Let's call it I-Rate.
Something else?
Well, the metal right. LP is what I've heard. I haven't heard the
like. It's called. This band was called Irate, though. I'm pretty sure with I Am Colossus and all that stuff.
No, the band is called Newstead because he is Jason Newstead. Unless he changed the name without my permission, in which case he must be destroyed.
No, no, there was an album released after Reload, like near the tail end of his tenure, in which he recorded an album called Irate. It's like two songs, and one of them is called I Am Colossus.
Yeah, that was a post Metallica project that led to his departure from that band. That was
a during Metallica. That was during a break in Metallica. That was a big thing about it. Yeah, Irate Sexturica was the name of the album. It's a combo album.
Whatever it's called, I need to go get more beer. I'll be back in 5 minutes.
Here, I'll drop a link for you though, just so you can see it.
Apparently, Fear Factory's coming out with a new album too.
Yes, they are. I forgot about that. Yes.
Me, are you still going to see them?
Wait, what happened? I'm sorry. I wasn't paying attention. Fear Factory? I was reading.
Fear Factory.
Yeah, I'm going to be seeing them tomorrow night with my buddy Drew.
Nice. They put on a great show. Well, they did.
I haven't been yet, so I'm pretty excited.
I've never been to one of their shows. I've been to Sabaton 3 times, except once. Weird Al once. Aelstorm / what is the name of that band?
It's a cool name. What was the name of that band?
The band, they're a power metal band from fucking Florida. I can't remember the name. Mia likes them, and I can't remember the fucking name.
Abney Park?
No.
We're not talking about them.
No. Abney's the Park's not power metal.
I know, that's why I'm like, no.
Hold on, let's just look at my album.
Just go through your shit. Mia does not read mine.
I'm doing it right now.
Mind reader?
Thank you.
My favorite song off of Death Magnetic was Judas Kissed. I felt like that was fucking proper Metallica, but a lot of Metallica fans didn't agree with me on that one, so...
I don't agree with you, but it definitely is a better song on the album.
Yes, down death to all butt metal. Because butt metal is just something you don't want.
Death to all false metal.
death to all butt metal.
Where the fuck are you getting that from? It's death to all false metal.
The quarter bucket of popcorn failed to satisfy.
The Steel Panther song, death
to
all
butt metal. Toast and peanut butter.
Oh, by the way, Steel Panther's not fucking metal. They can suck my cock.
Oh, yeah, I bet.
As good music as they make, it's not metal. It's fucking rock. They don't have the fucking right to say death at all but metal.
Oh, come on.
No.
Come on. They can't sing a song about metal being from outside of metal.
James in the chat says Death Magnetic was a lot better than Saint Anger.
Nah.
That's true. Yes. Philip,
was good, but really forgettable.
That's like comparing the worst thing in the world to...
Not the worst thing in the world.
Not the worst thing in the world. Camelot. Fuck, there's the name of the band. Camelot.
Let's not go to Camelot. It's a silly place.
If I knew where you were going with that, I would have been like, yeah.
On second thought, let's not go there.
I know, I'm sorry.
My favorite on that, since Sean mentioned it, was actually the Lego version they did. It was on the special edition DVD.
Yeah, I think I remember that.
Fucking hilarious. Animated, stop motion animated Legos.
Mm-hmm.
The best part about the AC is hearing all this talk about metal, I can't wait for the new season of Metalocalypse. I'm like, yes, if you actually listen to metal and are like into the metal scene, you get a lot more of the inside jokes that aren't like evidence. They're not really necessarily jokes. There's like a background thing, or they'll just have an off-thrown comment that I'll sit and watch with non-metal fans, and they're like sitting stone-faced. I'm cracking up because I get the fucking little reference. So I really appreciate that about the show. That it actually
it's good. That sounds like when I watch Futurama with non-sci-fi geeks.
Oh, totally.
Exactly.
I'm laughing my ass off. They're just like, huh?
They're like, so funny.
Justin, glasses are not for eating.
Oh, yes, they are.
But yeah, I absolutely love it a lot. That show, yes. Just yes, I want to own all the seasons on Blu-ray.
I watched an episode of Phineas and Ferb today, and they made an Army of Darkness reference.
Oh, yeah?
Really?
Yeah.
The guy
put, I was quite surprised. The show, actually.
The guy put a special glove on, and then he looked at his hand, squeezed something, and he was like, groovy. And I was like, that is Army of Darkness. And my 5-year-old niece was just like, duh?
Yeah, actually, there was a lot of references to movies in there. A lot of them.
Ever since SpongeBob got Pantera to do the music for one episode, the TV's been getting kind of ballsy with their obscure movie references.
Mm-hmm. How would they do Pantera for one episode?
If Dimebag was already dead.
Yeah, Pantera hasn't been a band for almost a decade by the time.
This episode of SpongeBob was probably about, you know, God, how many years ago was that episode?
I heard about Gwar doing an episode of Operation Kids Next Door, but I've never seen that episode.
That would be totally.
There was actually one really badass episode of Kids Next Door where the entire episode was dedicated to the Matrix.
Ah.
And it was actually really, really cool about how, you know, it was very, very similar about how kids are trying, they're trying to make them into adults.
Mm-hmm.
But it was a whole big parody on the Matrix. And it was just, it was pretty good, actually.
One of the things I miss about Disney Channel, or Family Channel, as we call it in Canada, there was a cartoon show based around primary school hall monitors. And they were trying to solve, like, basic violations of the hall monitor code. Like, people going to the bathroom without a ticket and skipping class and stuff like that. That was a good show.
James asks if anybody watches Avengers or Earth's Mightiest Heroes.
I watched that.
I've been meaning to watch that.
I've seen an episode or two.
Yeah. Heard it's good. I have not actually said I don't watch it yet.
It's okay, but so far.
I want to get the Blu-ray sets that were released here in Canada. They had both seasons on Blu-ray here.
It's weird, because I go from the Google Hangout tab to the live stream tab, and I see myself moving, but it's not syncing up with my lips.
No, there's like almost a 30-second delay.
For me, it's like almost a minute.
Hmm.
But yeah, here we go. It's the song Death Rattle by Pantera, and it's the episode of SpongeBob where Sandy has to go into hibernation, so she wants to get all this shit done before she goes into hibernation. They use Death Rattle by Pantera to to emphasize that she's like being completely epic and doing all these extremely dangerous things.
I love that
I'm
song.
Back. Nobody missed me.
You're right. Nobody missed you.
You left?
I will repeat what I said
for... skin slip.
Honestly, didn't even notice you'd left. I was too busy eating my toast.
Yeah, Skin Slip, they used the song in that SpongeBob episode. They used Death Rattle by Pantera.
Oh, they used a Pantera song. Okay.
Yeah, it has like, in the very beginning song it says... For it.
I was like, what?
Oh, no. They used they kind of did a specialized version of Death Rattle. And even the very beginning of the episode, it has, like, the credits. And then right the last credit is this big flaming sign that says, featuring Pantera.
The thing about Pantera that you got to remember is that all their recordings are now owned by the Rhino Recording Company.
Yep.
So... Really, all it takes to get a new Pantera single is to get Phil Anselmo into the recording studio to record an alternative vocal track. And there you go. You've got a new Pantera record.
Manic says, Rick Berman is now on Twitter and made a slip of the keyboard referring to Star Trek Into Darkness as Nemesis. Uh-oh.
I saw Star Trek in the Darkness without seeing the first Abrams Star Trek movie. I gotta say, I was really impressed with it. I thought it was a good fucking movie.
See the first one, too.
I would, but they took it off Netflix 2 days ago.
What? Where the fuck is the sense in that?
I don't want to talk. That would be because Paramount hates you. That's why.
Skin Slip, to answer your question about Pantera, this episode that they did was May 5th, 2001.
Yeah.
Doesn't matter. I think Pantera broke up before that, didn't they?
They broke up like 4 years before that, yeah. 3 years, sorry.
It's a SpongeBob episode of season 2.
Technically, yeah, they broke up and then they got back together in 2002? No, they broke up in 2000.
1981 to 2003, Wikipedia says.
Right, but they got back together in 2002, like
they broke
only
up
a year apart. Then Dimebag died in 2004, and that was pretty much the end of the day.
Yeah, they recorded their last album in 2000, and they toured together until 2003.
Yes. And then that's when Dimebag, they all died and all sad.
Yeah. Well,
yeah, but that's that whole.
We still have Down and Damage Plan and Supergiant Risk Rule and Hell Yeah.
Well, I don't really consider Damage Plan a band because I've never been a fan of any of the post Pantera Dimebag projects. So, yeah.
Yeah, well, I mean, Damage Plan was like. It was good, but it wasn't the same. It lacked the energy, I think.
Well, the thing about Pantera that you got to remember is that it was just like the stars aligning to create the band that Metallica could never be in the 90s. Because, let's face it, if you listen to Cowboys from Hell or Reinventing the Steel or Great Southern Trendkill, you're like, why isn't Metallica making these records? And I'll tell you why. It's because Bob Rock got involved.
No. Bob Rock just helped them. That was the problem. They had already started declining. If you listen to And the Justice for All, you'll see that they had already started losing their edge by the end of the... Like, the album was just basically full of hurt and anguish and then not the will to continue being a band that they were. The thing was that that Cliff Burton died and it took all their love for the world out of the music. And it just... Cause, and just for all, it's a fan favorite, but it's really just a hollow album. There's just fucking hatred and anger throughout it, but there's no love for what they're doing. It's so fucking mechanical.
Well, you gotta remember too that
what the fuck?
You know it, Sean. Sean is sucking himself off over there.
That was epic.
Yep.
You gotta remember though that Cliff Burton was the only member of Metallica that was educated in music theory up until that point. So,
right.
Nobody knew how to write actual functioning music after Cliff died. So that would be why
we
have...
That's why Bob Rock came in.
Yeah.
But you can tell by Load and Reload that they had learned how to at least make functioning music. Even if you didn't agree with it, the music was at least... It actually meant something to them. It meant... You know what I mean? Like, it had heart back in it. Because the Black Album was just fucking pop music, essentially. No offense. I mean, it's a good album. It's still fucking pop
music. I'm trying to answer Frank's question.
Other than, like, a few songs. Oh, I'm sorry. Fine.
Well, I'm just saying the chat's kind of moved on from it. They're talking about other stuff. How about Star Trek 2 and...
You know, yeah. I've heard a lot of people saying about Star Trek 2 that it borrows from what it is in Star Trek 2, so they're right.
Well,
but
the problem
here's the thing. Here's the thing. They're allowed to do that. They're allowed to do that because they set up in the first movie that this is an alternate reality, an alternate universe of Star Trek. So it's kind of makes sense that some of the same stuff is happening different way.
Well, to answer Frank's question, it's not very different, but
We'll see how long it takes them to notice.
One thing you probably didn't know. You might not, you might know that Don Stroller is at half the episode. No one's here yet. They're playing music while
I just noticed Absalom Doc laughs like Stoutman.
I am Absalom Doc.
Sorry, were you trying to say something, Stoud?
No, not at all. No, just like half the people in the chat trying to have a conversation with people, you know, in the live stream. And you were blasting some, I don't know what the fuck that was, because I was muted.
I just got tired of the metal discussion, so it was time to put an end to it.
I was trying to siphon off the metal discussion because people were talking about Star Trek. And
oh, I know. I know you were, but they weren't having any of it. The only thing that was going to work was excessive trolling.
Hold on. You started that. Actually, we'd already finished the fucking metal conversation. We're on Star Trek. So go figure. That's all I have to say.
See, I think Master Puppets is the best album, but really...
Fuck!
Absolutely.
That's it. What else do I have here? I got some Katamari Damashi, maybe? That'd be good.
I hate how people in the UK call it Katamari Damacy. I'm like, what the fuck is Damacy? It's Damashi.
It's Damashi. Listen to the lyrics of your own damn song.
My face is numb.
Why is it Ron in here?
So yes, as I will say entirely of my own opinion and without any influence from the text chat at all regarding Star Trek. Yes, Star Trek, the new movies are in fact an alternate universe, and that's just the way it is, so deal with it. As Star Trek fans should understand and accept this concept that really should not be difficult.
I was waiting for Stoud to rage there for a second.
One of my favorite things about the Abrams Star Trek is that Spock.
I'll give you my own personal thoughts. They can take whatever they want from other movies and do it a bit differently.
Music,
it's an alternate universe. That's just the way it is. Deal
What's
with
funny
it.
Is I just think is every Smiley. Time they want to do their own thing in Star Trek, every time they want to do their own thing, they just go, it's an alternate universe.
Why not?
How many fucking alternate universes is this damn thing?
There's a lot.
Right now?
Well, I mean, according to quantum theory, it's infinite. There's an infinite number of alternate universes.
One of mine.
Who the fuck is opening potato chips on my iPhone?
One of my favorite things about...
fuck all you people who have potato chips. Sorry, what, Matt? Metal?
Said, one of my favorite things about the JJ.
Damn it. Thank you. Thank you. Okay. Metal, you were saying?
I've not seen such bravery. Someone shot a food.
I love to hurt people.
Yes. You were saying, Metal?
I said my favorite thing about the J.J. Abrams Star Trek is that this is the last one.
This is the last one. I thought you didn't mind the latest one, though.
Nah, I liked the first one.
Oh, okay, you liked the first one.
The last one upset me quite a bit. It was still an enjoyable movie, but an enjoyable Star Trek movie? No, not at all.
But upsetting.
My favorite thing is that Spock can come back and talk to Spock.
Well, this is true. He can get advice from himself.
I want to talk about it, though, but I can't talk about it without spoilers.
Yeah, it's okay. In a few months, the Blu-ray will come out, and then we can talk about it. Yeah, I'm sure all your thoughts and feelings will be just as fresh.
Just hold the bag up.
Like the opening sequence, there's a big argument about the fact that Kirk flies in the face of the Prime Directive. That's the whole mission that they were there flies in the face of the Prime Directive, and that's the whole movie flies in the face of Star Trek. I'm sorry.
Oh, okay.
I
can't dispute or agree or disagree with you because I haven't seen the movie.
But, you gotta remember, though.
Okay. Your opinion is noted.
Like I said, I can't even talk about it.
I can contribute nothing more than that.
All I can say, Metal, it actually does fit into the plot continuity of this particular film.
Is talking! God damn it.
No. Actually, you weren't.
So shut up.
You gotta remember, though, that RoboCop gave Kirk permission to shit all over the Prime Directive.
Okay.
Kirk, he's all like, fuck the Prime Directive. Go get Khan. And
James asks, hey, Z, you going to pick up the Blu-ray for The Howling when it comes out later this month? I'd love to. I don't know if I'm going to pick it up right away, but I will get it eventually.
Why do I come to these?
Well, we are going to probably pick up right away. To not give spoilers away. That's
no, no, don't.
Spoilers. And Zen and Isaac here are going to both get the Amityville horror box set that comes out.
Yes, absolutely.
That's going to be amazing.
Yeah, definitely looking forward to that. That's needed proper treatment for a long time. And the big news about it, of course, is we get Amityville 3D in 3D for the first time since its theatrical release, which is pretty awesome. Not that it's a great
Blu-ray.
Movie, but we get it in 3D.
It's 3D.
Yeah.
Yep.
Wait, so you guys were about to ask me a question?
No.
I hate you all.
Ron says
I have this edition of the Howling.
Why did it upset you? I say it was better than the last one. Ah, fuck it. And then he says, yes, yes! And then goes on to say, achoo! And then he goes on to say, JJ knows nothing of Star Trek. He knows Star Wars, LOL. And then Stoud says, this is why they got him for Star Wars.
What the fuck are you saying?
And then Ron and then says, and I'm actually looking forward to episode 7.
What the fuck?
And then Stoud says, watching Star Trek and Into Darkness had the profound effect on me of comforting me in my belief that Abrams would do an excellent job with Star Wars, especially with Disney footing the bill.
I don't know. It had the opposite effect on me.
Manic. Leonard Nimoy was not asked to be in Star Wars. Why the fuck would he be asked in Star Wars?
Just to piss off the Star Wars fanboys.
That was a April Fool's joke.
Watch Red Letter Media's review of Star Trek Into Darkness.
I love that. The Plinkett review.
I will watch it after I see the movie, yes. Sure.
They express a lot of my problems with the movie.
Really?
Yes.
I love how it kind of blatantly ends off at the with him just still going into it and going into it, and then he's just like, fuck this.
Fuck it.
Leonard Nimoy lied. He's the doctor.
Hey, lens flare in outer space where you're likely to see lens flare. Let's just be fair.
No. There's no light in space. What are you talking about?
Lens
just
flare.
All blackness.
That's why there's stars.
Lens flare on the bridge, though. I mean,
well, the bridge you can control
lots of shiny
the lighting. You have control over that. Why would you willingly want lights that are so bright they shine, causing lens flare in your eyes?
It is in the future.
Shining directly into your eyes at all times from every angle when you're trying to steer the damn ship.
You see, folks, this is why I don't come to movie gangbangs.
Because they have retina implants that cut out the glare.
Or they could just turn down the fucking lights.
Like, oh, fuck, lens flare, oh.
It hurts.
Star Wars Episode 7, A New Flare.
Ron said that just to piss me off. He knows what? How much I love Quantum Leap. He's just like, how about if J.J. Abrams shits on your favorite show, huh?
Oh.
Fuck you!
Lens flare in the deleted shower scene.
Yeah.
I want...
Frank says he finds Quantum Leap depressing.
I would be okay with lens flare and Quantum Leap.
Is it because
the point?
He's constantly trying to get home and never gets home?
Did you guys hear the big news about
the
Deadpool movie?
It's literally the saddest ending ever.
Wow. Really?
What's the big news about the Deadpool movie?
I never saw the final one. I thought you would want to take that one, Stoud, but okay.
Deadpool movie, big news.
Deadpool movie.
Script is done for the Deadpool movie.
Okay.
Well, that's not news. That's been done for ages.
Fox won't greenlight it.
Because they
Robert
want it to
Robert Rodriguez is in talk to direct it, even though they won't greenlight it.
Ah, so maybe he can exercise some of his Robert Rodriguez clout and get it happening.
Like, it'd be like this. Look, awesome. Look, guys. You could say yes to this movie and you make money, or I'll go to Troublemaker Studios, make it, and then I'll release it on the internet and I don't give a fuck.
Yeah.
You know what?
He's got the fucking money. The guy makes movies that we'll never see.
Yeah.
Well, apparently there's a...
He's been working on a fucking Blade Runner-esque movie for the last 10 years. He's got it fucking practically in the can.
Well, he did a whole remake of Barbarella, right? And nobody ever saw the thing. So...
Who did?
Right. He's Prince.
Really?
Of movies. He's putting, fucking movies in the vault.
Yeah, he's got remakes of. He's got fucking movies out. He's been making movies for the last 10 years, but nobody will fucking release them.
Yeah,
that's just how badass Robert Rodriguez
is. Robert Rodriguez is awesome.
He makes such badass movies that no
film studio. I applied for an internship.
Isn't he based in Texas?
I applied for an internship for the summer, but I got turned down.
Oh, why'd you get turned down?
He's in Austin.
Was there a reason or?
He's literally 1 mile that way.
A block away.
Oh, they just had a lot of people. Oh, okay. So I was just one of the people who didn't make it.
Ah, there we go.
Everybody
was. A mile
was...
away, that way.
Ron asks, is there a way to get a hold of those unreleased movies? Yes, no Robert Rodriguez personally, and I'm sure he'll show them to you. Yeah. Have you around for a Texas barbecue and watch some of his unreleased movies.
If Robert Rodriguez is anything like Trent Reznor... The only way you're going to get a view of his unreleased movies is if he gives you a copy of those movies.
Yeah.
Because apparently Trent Reznor made a 45-minute movie that only 5 people have ever seen.
Yeah. Cool.
One of them being Marilyn Manson, and he apparently put his copy online. So...
Good old Marilyn Manson.
He has a girl's name and a guy's name.
Rodriguez.
He does.
Rodriguez has had the rights to the Madman comic book for like 15 years and still hasn't seen that from the screen yet, which is sad.
Armor is getting fancy with their Vienna sausages and making Chipotle flavors.
Ooh. Sounds good.
Chipotle. The other one I had earlier was bourbon barbecue. I go, holy crap, dude. Someone found a budget.
No doot about it.
I had steak for dinner tonight.
So did I.
Fuck you. So you keep saying. And so I keep saying, fuck you.
I had a porterhouse steak.
God damn all you people and your steak.
I had a
Monday. I will have steak on Monday. Monday steak.
Monday steak.
Yeah, there will be a special Monday night edition of Saturday Night Insanity. We can watch Saturday
just,
night
just to watch me steak. Eat steak. Yes.
That
you can watch me make
sausage.
Steak and eat steak. Ooh, that looks good.
For people who don't know.
That looks
it's pretty much it's a hot dog. Pretty much.
Yeah.
So
I love hot dogs.
Me too.
Has the right to do the Barbarella movie? Red Sonja remake, Fire and Ice remake, and a movie for a new animated heavy metal film.
Yep.
Cool.
All those things he's working on.
Yep.
Plus, he's got a Blade Runner script that he's been filming, Sin City 2. I mean, he's got shit. He just needs to put it out.
I can't wait for Sin City 2.
Awesome. We did.
Yeah, Sim City 2 is going to be awesome. I, too, am looking forward to Sim City 2.
Hey, I enjoyed Sim City 1.
Was there even a Sim City 1?
Yes.
Never even heard of it.
Sim City 2013 is Sim City 1.
Welcome back, Mia. Oh, it's Ron. Never mind. Well, Ron,
now Mia can't get back.
You better be fucking amazing right now, because Mia just gave up her spot for you.
I told her not to.
Be amazing.
Your thoughts on Star Trek, go.
I was in my deleted shower scene, that's why I told her not to give up the...
Your deleted shower scene?
Just got out. Oh, yeah.
Wait. There's the deleted shower scene that I haven't seen yet?
Yes.
You haven't seen
starring
that
Ron.
Yeah. Tom, Ron, whatever.
I'm not picky towards who's in the shower. I just want to see the scene.
It's like finding the deleted shower scene in the friggin' Street Fighter animated movie.
Yeah, I have the flipper disc that has the U.S. the uncut U.S. version and the more uncut Japanese version. The more uncut Japanese version has more of the shower scene. And yep. more of Chun-Li fighting Vega tits. In her underwear.
I sort of approve.
They're animated, but hey, they're tits.
They're very well drawn.
Hey,
exceptional artistic skill.
They're better than seeing Jackie Chan dressed up as Chun-Li. Let's put it
that way.
I was waiting for someone to mention that.
Yes. By a very slim
That's
margin.
That's awesome. What are you talking about?
Is that real?
That yeah. is real.
Very slim.
You ever seen it? Oh my god.
Look up Chan-Li.
It's amazing.
On YouTube. Chan-Li.
Google image. YouTube.
Or YouTube or Google. Well, YouTube if it's you want amazing. To see the whole scene, or Google image if you just want to see.
What's funny is it's using very basic forms of camera manipulation, but it's
I like
they get the moves down pretty well.
Yeah,
I like how everybody is just leaving the hangout periodically
in the hopes that Mia comes back.
Like, oh wait, we can leave? Holy shit.
But everyone's too egotistical to give up a spot for Mia. We're all just too damn full of ourselves.
Yep. To worship.
Some toast crumbs went down the wrong way.
Mia.
James says, anybody here 300 is getting a sequel. I heard they were talking about...
300
doing
it's already done.
Frank says, Sean, I'm surprised you didn't make a video that Inspector Gadget Complete Series is coming out on DVD. I just haven't had time to make videos this week much. I did post about it on the Facebook page with Amazon links to all the pre-order pages. I just have not had time. Plus, what little time I have had has been focused on the Doctor Who 50th anniversary stuff, so I just haven't been able to get to it. But there will be videos of some kind about it at some point. I definitely want to order them. They're pretty affordable, too. They're like under $20 a volume, and the whole series is spread across 4 volumes, all being released simultaneously. So,
I'm running out of reasons to subscribe to Teletoon Retro with all these retro cartoons coming to DVD.
Yeah, well, I've got Beetlejuice on the way, and Inspector Gadget is coming out. That's very true, because, here, the only cable channel that I actually watch is Teletoon Retro. That's it.
Well, I mean...
I could give a shit about all the other cable channels, honestly.
If you're
Teletoon
like me...
Retro.
If you're like me, you only watch Teletoon Retro on Friday nights between 8 and 11 anyways.
Yeah.
So, you see Ninja Turtles, Transformers, Thundercats, She-Ra, He-Man...
And I have all of those on DVD.
Yeah. So it's like you're running out of reasons to watch Teletoon Retro unless you want to watch Garfield and Friends at 7 o'clock p.m. But let's face it, you've got that already.
I've got...
So you don't.
I'm still missing the last 3 volumes of Garfield and Friends. There's still a chunk of it I haven't seen in a long time.
Now,
but,
I don't have
any of them.
Is it...
I got all of them.
Is it true
all of them, no.
Is it true that they took the Orson's Farm segments out of the DVDs, or is
no.
that just something
they're
that's
still in there,
on,
but they're
right?
called Orson's Farm now
instead
Acres.
Of U.S. Acres, yeah. But
to
no, they're
to
all
our
there.
Canadian friends,
they're all there. The only thing they changed was the intro.
Okay.
Yeah, as a kid.
Like how she's like how that wildlife organization sued the WWF into changing their name to the WWE like 20 fucking years later after it had been firmly established as a brand.
Yeah,
because
no one has ever confused wildlife and wrestling.
That was such bullshit.
Really
I'm not even a wrestling fan.
WWE?
I consider that bullshit.
Well, I mean,
so now, I mean, now all the DVD releases of the old WrestleManias and all the old events, they actually censor out any mention of WWF as an abbreviation. They cut out of the commentaries. They have to blur it out of the image.
They actually became to an agreement.
Yeah.
They recently came to an agreement to allow the previous footage to have all those references. That's just brand new. That happened this year.
Oh, that's good. So now they can re-release everything and make even more money.
Now they're like, hey.
So my Sega Genesis copy.
That's actually pretty awesome.
They actually didn't, though, because they re-released WrestleMania, and it's still censored. They didn't bother on censoring it.
I am still on the hunt for the N64 version of WrestleMania. That was by far my favorite wrestling game of all time.
I think SmackDown for the PlayStation 1 was my favorite.
Though considered by every wrestling game fan ever is WWF No Mercy, but the N64 is considered the greatest wrestling game of all time.
Yeah, that
not
was the second.
Not personal favorite, just, you know.
Mostly the reason I
like was partial to Attitude, because, even though it's terrible.
Is because it's the one I learned how to play, and it's the one that has the badass Kane intro.
Scott was mentioning your Western movie marathon. I don't know if you saw that.
Oh.
Look in the text right there.
Thank you.
But, Frank said
I'm really glad
chat.
A lot of people liked it, you know.
That here in the U.S., our equivalent to Teletoon Retro in the U.S. here is called Boomerang.
Yeah, that's what I was wondering. Boomerang.
Yeah, there you go.
Sounds Boomerang. Very much like Boomerang.
Yeah.
Boomerang. That, you know, that's where you watch the Smurfs, SWAT Cats, you can watch He-Man, She-Ra, you know, all those old shows. Pretty much everything. It was pretty much a network created by Hanna-Barbera.
Yeah.
It's pretty much Boomerang. What it was and what it is. And that's one Boomerang and the Sci-Fi Channel.
My personal
two things
favorite
I miss.
Wrestling game on the
Hi, guys.
Hi, Dallin. How's it going?
Fucking good, dude. I rode a gun today.
You rode a gun?
I rode a motorcycle that was so fast it was like riding a gun.
Oh, okay. There you go. Awesome.
I thought you were going to say I drove a tank.
Yeah, I was going to say, you riding the turret.
You rode a gun. You drove a tank.
Fire off a couple shots.
Pretty
I'm ready.
Gun on top of
a damn it.
I thought that I had the best day. Now I got to go fucking drive a tank. That sounds awesome.
I have my moments where I like to go.
Yeah, you literally need to drive a tank.
The FPS Russia.
Literally.
Could have flown that right there.
Just watch them blow shit up with big ass guns.
FPS Russia was born on the exact same day as I was. Same year,
really?
Same day. Yep.
His accent, his Russian accent is awesome. He goes, hello, this is FPS Russia.
Oh, FPS Russia. Yeah, he's hilarious.
Yeah, he's a cool guy. I mean,
he's
really
cool.
Like,
I've watched
some
of his stuff.
Shit. Yeah. They were going
I love that
to fire
Russia.
Some
he's great.
Shit that other shit.
He's not actually Russian, right? He's
no,
actually
he's
like
not.
Some guy from Kentucky.
No,
exactly.
He's not actually.
He's like some fucker from Kentucky who works at a gun store.
Is he really?
Take stuff.
Right,
out
right. That's what I thought. Yeah.
It's his. It's he created an internet persona.
That's hilarious.
Yeah.
It's great. Yeah. No, it's hilarious shit. I love his persona.
Yeah. So we were plugging him right now. If you haven't seen him. Go watch him and subscribe because it's a fucking awesome YouTube channel.
It's all right.
If you happen to be him, you're welcome to send me a direct message on Twitter and I will get you in this hangout.